Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Aditya Gupta and I again have with me Dr. Pankhudi. So I am currently doing my DM in Pediatric Oncology and she's pursuing her SRship in Dermatology after having done her MD from AIIMS and after IME having completed my MD in Pediatric from AIIMS already. So this video is about depression and other videos which will tell you a lot about what depression is. We believe that in medicine, at least in the medical community, a bit of awareness definitely has come that, okay, these disorders are real and we need to deal with them. We are at risk for them just by the virtue of the fact that we're medical students or we are doctors, we don't become immune to them. But despite that awareness, what's lacking is how to approach it. So for someone, it's very natural for us. If you see someone who gets sick or who, let's say, falls on the road, we know what to do at that point of time. We know what kind of first aid to give or how to approach a person who's sick. But when it comes to mental health disorders, be it depression, anxiety, or any other, our approaches, A, are wrong, or B, we in general don't have any idea. So this video is aimed at that. Hopefully, we'll be able to create just a tiny bit of awareness in this ocean of knowledge that, you know, whatever is there. So
and just to add, this is different from all the videos that he has done which tells you how to take a branch or how to do branch. This is just about how to recognize these signs in either yourself or somebody else, and more importantly, what not to do and a little of what you can do if you think that somebody, you or somebody around you, might be facing any mental health issues including depression, anxiety. The idea is that we are trying to talk to people who want to help, who are the good Samaritans, who will not leave a person lying on the road, who will approach and help, who will not just stand by, watch or talk about it. So if you're somebody who believes that mental health illnesses either don't exist or are just in the mind and are just an excuse to cut work used by some people, or who actually use it as a stigmatized thing, who talk to other people and tell them that, oh, this person is dealing with this or maybe going to a psychiatrist, this is not for you. I don't think you're going to benefit from spending more time on this.
It's better if you actually just stop right now
and go to any of his other videos if you want.
For that matter,
Yes, but if you would be actually wanted to talk about this, because this is something very close to both our hearts, this is something that we've both dealt with, both personally as well as people around us, and we think that in our own experience we have been able to help some other people as well, not by taking it on us, and we will come to that, but by just being there. So we've told you that why we are doing this, why, who is it for, and now we'll come what not to do.
So if you're dealing with somebody, people know that a lot of people, especially those who think that they want to help a person, everybody actually starts with ki ye karna chahiye ya ye nahi karna chahiye. But the very first principle in medicine is primum nocere, that is, first do no harm. So rather, instead of talking about what you can do to help, we'll first talk about things that, even though you are doing it properly in your good intentions, you're trying to be a good Samaritan, but you might end up causing a slightly more harm.
Yeah, and actually Aditya gave me a very good example of that when you go in for first aid and if you think that the person might have a neck injury, you do not move that person. So you just make sure that you do not end up causing more harm and you let it be. So that is, it's important to know. So similarly, when dealing with anybody who might be at risk of or who might actually be dealing with a mental health issue, we want you to know what not to say, even if you think it sounds like absolutely reasonable advice. Something like, chal movie dekhne chalte hain, you'll feel better.
Yeah, so if someone says chal movie dekhne chalte hain, absolutely not. Something similar, म्यूजिक सुन ले, यू विल फील बेटर.
या कोई हॉबी शुरू क्यों नहीं कर लेता तू, लोगों से मिला कर, तू कमरे से निकल,
तू लोगों से जाके यू नो, तू अपने काम में ज्यादा इन्वॉल्व हो जा. आज यू नो, इफ यू फील, देखो रूम पे बैठ के बुरे थॉट्स आ रहे हैं, तू काम पे ही रह कर काम में ज्यादा इन्वॉल्व हो जा, बिकम अ वर्कहोलिक समथिंग.
रोज धूप में निकला करो, तुम नेचर की सैर करोगे, तुम बिल्कुल ठीक हो जाओगे.
कहीं घूम के आ, ट्रैवल इज द बेस्ट मेडिसिन पॉसिबल.
एब्सोल्युटली, एंड इट्स ओके, सब ठीक हो जाएगा. अरे सब ठीक हो जाता है,
चल मेरे साथ वो कॉमेडी शो देखने चल पड़, एक बार हंसेगा तेरी हंसी हर समय वापस आ जाएगी, एटलीस्ट ये तो करके देख.
Yes.
What's the harm?
Yes, and any kind of tough love which involves ki hum, just because your intentions are good, then anything that even hurtful that you say is in the long run supposed to help that person. Please, please don't use any of these things, even if they seem absolutely reasonable to you. Because what you're doing is that, see, if somebody has fallen on the road, and this is again an example that we covered, that somebody's fallen on the road, you don't walk up to them and tell them, khade ho ja. Agar wo khud khade ho sakte, so they would have gotten up already if they could. So
if somebody is having a fracture, you just don't simply go to them and say, ki chal chalna shuru kar, to apne aap theek ho jayega, then your fracture will heal on its own.
Absolutely.
So anything on these lines, which you might be thinking is maybe beneficial for them, be it listening to music, be it laughing out loud on a comedy video, be it having their favorite drink or favorite meal, or going on travel. For you might feel that they are going to be helpful, but they might not either be in a state, or they are simply are not, it's not simply possible, both physically and mentally, to do any of these.
The whole reason they've ended up where they've ended up, or including if you're feeling the way you're feeling, is because you have not been able to use these smaller tools to bring yourself out of it. It's only then that we call it depression, when it is persistent low mood for a prolonged period of time. It won't be called depression otherwise.
So while your intentions and saying all these things that we just discussed might be true, might be good in order to pick that person up in whatever way, they might just end up causing more harm than what you intend to, actually, for that matter of fact. So in a subset, what we can say is anything that you think is becomes a goal for that person, even the tiniest amount of it, be it even listening to their favorite song, that becomes a goal for that matter of fact. In such a scenario, that goal setting for that repressed person can actually be more harmful than than actually helping that person. So make sure that, try to avoid it.
Yes, and also goal setting is a technique used by some psychologists, and there it is under professional supervision. So like we say, don't try those stunts at home. Do not try to fix people on your own. You are not skilled enough to do that. And you are out of your depth.
Unless you are actually are an MD in psychiatry.
Yes.
But
In which case?
Yeah. Definitely. It brings us to how can you actually help?
Yes.
So the one thing that you can definitely do as far as help is concerned. So just like in our wards, when there is a transfer of duty, for example, if some person comes to you that I'm feeling very suicidal or I'm feeling very depressed and I just want to stay with you this night, your responsibility does not end at the end of the night. It will end when you transfer that duty. And in hope, in a very what it should ideally end with, that you actually help that person go to a mental health professional. They are the ones who are trained to deal with it. They are the ones who will can and hopefully will make a difference towards the betterment of that person's mental health profile. So like she said, don't try these stunts at home. They are for professionals. So the thing that you can actually do is get them to a professional.
Right. So if you feel that any of your friends or anybody around you might be suffering from any kind of mental illness, first talk to them. And when we say talk to them, we are talking about, so there are two ways of talking to them. One is that be around. So a lot of us, when we go to a person who we demand their attention and we demand a response, that we have deigned to come to you and we've made this time for you, why don't you tell us what is wrong with you? Oftentimes they don't know what is wrong. They are just feeling persistently low and they feel like everything is their fault, and demanding their time is actually going to make them feel a lot
worse,
actually,
for that matter of fact.
Yes. And if you're doing this as a favor, you're allotting giving them time as a favor, don't do it. It's better to not, than don't show presence as you would do for a person who's physically ill. Only go there if you mean to stay there, if you mean to be there, and if you mean to not demand anything in return at that point of time. Yes, and actually really being a friend. And I understand that friendship is about give and take, but you don't have to take right at that time when the person does not have the ability to give anything.
Actually, this brings me to the most important thing. The one thing that you can actually be there is just be there.
Yeah.
So
as simple as that.
Yeah. So when I had this phase in my life, whenever I did that, the best thing that my friends actually did was they just used to be in my room. I used to be there in my bed laying and not doing anything for the matter of fact. They just used to be there. They used to watch Friends in my room. On my laptop for that matter of fact. They used to study their own books, but they were just there. They were not telling me, ki chal humare saath tu aaj khana khane chal rahe. You love butter chicken, let's have butter chicken. They were not telling me, let's go to this particular place in town, yahan pe koi concert chal raha hai or anything for that matter of fact. They did not tell me ki arey teko to travel bahut pasand hai, chal Ladakh chalte hain or something on those lines. They were literally just there. Okay, so they were there for 2-3 hours. Whenever they had the time, they came. Whenever they felt they can leave, they left. But they were just there. They were presence itself can matter more than, you know, your words or your supposed acts of kindness instead of that. So,
and these were not doctors per se, they were undergraduates, so they were as unskilled as you are, you or maybe even I without a degree in psychology. So all that matters is a good intention and not doing any harm by demanding something or demanding even attention.
So in a nutshell, what we're just trying to say is, don't set a goal. That's one thing that you should not do. And what you should do is help that person seek professional help. And if you yourself want to help, just be there. That's all.
Yeah. And take them to somebody, a therapist. Just even if they feel or you feel that they do not need anything, just get them evaluated. The same way you would show a skin lesion to me and ask me that, is this malignant? Does this need biopsy? Similarly, show the person to a therapist and ask them that, does this need medication? Does this need attention? Or is this okay? Is this within normal limits? Same, because the same way you do not know how to diagnose a mole from a melanoma, you do not know how to diagnose between something which is within normal limits for mental health and something that isn't. So we really hope that this helps, and please let us know if there's something that we can do to increase the toolkit or increase your ability to deal with these people. And don't outrightly deny anything that is being told to you by such a person, even if what they're saying is completely untrue according to you. Even if they say something like, I'm a waste of space, don't say you're not. Because that would make them feel, I'm wrong about everything. Mm-hmm. What you can do is say that, I am sorry that you feel this way, but do you think there's anything I can do to make you feel better? So, and if they don't talk to you, just be there.
Exactly. So that's exactly what I was coming to. You don't need to say anything to show your presence. You don't need to do anything to show your presence. You can act like literally just be there. And that's one thing that you can do.
Just
you
sit with them and be with them as they feel what they are feeling, and you feeling what you're feeling, and you doing what you want to do.
Sometimes all they want is a physical presence. So yeah.
And
so,
they don't even know that they want that.
Alright. Hopefully this video is able to bring a tiniest modicum of change in our behaviors and our attitudes. So hopefully you enjoyed it. So thank you.
And on a parting note, it is not about the branch you take. It's not about the stream you take. Dermat, pediatrics, no difference in terms of how we ended up.
It's not that only clinical branches people will end up having, you know, depression or mental health issue because they're under a lot of stress, and a person who's like, you know, chilling in radio or derma or, you know, something else will not. This is all pervasive or just
ubiquitous, like, more common
than
you think.
We can actually think.
So yeah. Bye. All the best.
Thank you.